Alright folks, here we are again from the BlizzCon 2010 Invitational, the Lost Games. It's like the Lost Levels in Mario All-Stars, except funner. And we have White Raw versus Next Genius. White Raw is going to be our red player down here in the bottom left of Steps of War. And actually I think this is this was the Loser's Bracket Final. Whoever won this went on to play Loner in the finals, so... Now you probably know who won it, but oh well. F ya. So, we got both Protoss players spawning on Steps of War. And these are the games that did not get cast at BlizzCon. So, if I didn't go to BlizzCon, I would really want to see them. And even if I did go to BlizzCon, which I did, I would really want to see these. So that's why I'm casting them, because I really want to see them. I don't know about the way they do their tournaments at BlizzCon, man. They're like, let's not show 80% of the games. Let's just show, like, four of them. And then we'll show Warcraft 3. Sound good? And break. That's what they do. So there's a gateway going down on 12. Similarly, a gateway going down on 12 for our friend White Raw. Duckload Raw is his name in this tournament. I guess Duckload is some sort of, like, skin-enhancing vitamin in Sweden or wherever he's from, White Raw's from. And, no, it's not. Duckload's like an internet thing, but, that's his sponsor. It's not just a silly, somewhat adult, inappropriate animality. I mean, bestiality name. I said animality, because Mortal Kombat rules. And, any divergences in the build so far? So far, no. There's the second pylon. Their builds are almost identical, except for White Raw is chrono boosting some probes. Yeah, that's really the only differences in these builds so far. There's a Cybernetics Core and a Cybernetics Core. So these guys are... Builds are mirrored. And this probe's just in here being an all-around jerk. White Rose gonna want to get a Stalker out as soon as he can. I don't know. You don't want to accidentally lose a probe. Because look, this one's not losing shields. It's just taking little shots here. In the meantime, this guy's just hitting the pylon. Next Genius's micro is better. Proof, right here. Next Genius's micro is better. He's bothering to mess with this probe just in case he sneaks out a probe kill. But the Cybernetics Core is almost done, so there's a second gateway pylon. Doopada doopada doopada. And the average APM much higher for Next Genius. That's what happens when you mess with those probes so much. Second gas goes down for Next Genius, and still only one gas for White Raw. So finally we're seeing these builds branch off down different paths. I am by no means a PvP expert. So this matchup's a little bit foreign to me. I mean, obviously, still know the basics. I know basically everyone builds Colossi. That's what I know. And Next Genius's White Raw's probe escaped the Stalker's wrath, and still waiting on his first Stalker is White Raw. Looks like he's gonna pop out right now and actually catch Next Genius's probe after he spent all that time microing it. Tisk tisk, my friend. And there's the second gate going down on almost 30, or not the second gate, second gas going down on almost 30 for White Raw. This has been up for a while, for Next Genius, and he is getting three gates up. And got the sentry up just in case of emergency. And over here in the production tab, it looks like Next Genius's warp gates are going to be up slightly ahead, and yeah, it's pretty similar on the worker count, so... pure Stalker so far for White Raw, with Next Genius opting for Sentry. It looks like he's going to be aggressive with these Stalkers, so the Sentries were going to be a good call. These Stalkers aren't going to get anything done with these two Sentries here blocking the ramp, so looks like the better decision went to Next Genius in this case. Looks like he is going to try and warp in some stuff. He has a pylon right here. I don't know what this probe's for. Maybe if he gets up the ramp, he'll put a pylon up there or something. I don't know, but here comes the probe, checking stuff out, and he's like, whoa, I did not, guys, settle down. So here comes a bunch of Stalkers, and is he going to get the force field off? He really needs to, yeah. And, with these two sentries here, it's not going to matter. As you can see, force field is 50 energy. This guy's got two in him, this guy's almost got a third, so it shouldn't be too big of an issue. And, Next Genius is just going to continue to warp in safely. While getting his Arubo up. Oh, trying to tease out a force field. There's White Raw. Didn't quite fall for it, though. And, Yeah, they're both still going really, really similar builds. You put some zealot at the front, two zealots actually, which is interesting. I guess that'll just block and slow down just in case the stalkers try and sneak up there. I think that's probably not necessary, but maybe he just wants a couple zealots in his composition. So there's the Robo Bay, and as soon as it comes out, here comes the Observer to watch the bottom of the ramp. That's really Next Genius's only concern right now, is watching this stalkers trying to get up the ramp. And yeah, until then, looks like Next Genius is moving ahead slowly in the probe count, making a lot of zealots is White Raw. He's not warping him in though, he's got him back at the base. So now Next Genius sees the bottom of the ramp and he's got nothing to worry about. Looks like White Raw is going to expand possibly, since he's got these protective zealots out here. And this force of zealots and stalkers and sentries is going to chase this out. He tried to force field a stalker in to trap him, but it didn't quite work. Would have been cool, but it wasn't. Instead, it was lame. Oh, lamest force fields ever because of like a centimeter. That's the way StarCraft is, men. You got to be careful. So this is the Observer checking everything out, and he sees right on time the robotics bay. I mean, I don't think any Protoss player's ever been surprised by seeing this, and but still, it's good to know that it's there. Taking a look at the production tab, actually, extended thermal lance already going up for White Rod. In the meantime, the same thing along with a Colossi. So Next Genius's Colossi is going to be out about 20 seconds sooner than White Raw's, but obviously that's not a huge deal unless there's a really well-timed attack, which could happen. And there's White Raw finally getting ready to expand. Yeah, I know PvP is a lot about the one base Colossi, which I don't know. I think if I think a matchup being very commonly played one base style is a sign of an unhealthy matchup, if you know what I mean. Like, a matchup that needs improvement is one that doesn't rely on economy so too heavily. Obviously, since these players are both at 73 and 70 food, and they're just now deciding to expand, that's obviously a pretty late expansion. And but that's a common timing in this matchup. So I'm not sure what needs to be tweaked, but something needs to be tweaked in this matchup because no one likes to watch this. Well, not only does no one like to watch it, but it doesn't lead to lots of expansive metagame, and it's not as fun for the players. It's not as dynamic of a matchup if you can't implement these fast expands and these taking when to take my third. Oh man, I'm doing well in my games, but I don't know when to take my third, and sometimes it screws me. Those kind of questions are the signs of a healthy matchup in StarCraft. So we'll see what happens. And they're both just expanding and protecting their expansion while producing Colossi. And Colossi are big bugs. They're big metal bugs with lasers. I don't know where their face is. I guess that's their face, this bug here. Whoa, come back. Hey. Hey, turn around, dude. Dude. Dude, okay, thank you. So I guess that's their face. See, I always thought that was like their eye, but I guess that's their little hat. So, face, hat, top of the morning to you. Colossi nod. And here comes a push from White Raw, just taking a shot at the assimilator to sh really show Next Genius who's boss. Nice assimilator. Balls. That's actually Next Genius's nickname in Korea. Balls. Yeah, look it up. And just trying to get a good spread here. I don't know. Right now, taking a look at the armies, I would gotta say that, especially with these sentries involved, they both have three Colossi, but I think these sentries are gonna help a lot in a fight. Given the Guardian Shield and the Force Field. Force Field. And looks like he's going to try and swing around the back here. And there's the first Colossi shots going down on each other. The first shots did go to Next Genius. Zealots are going to run in here, but it looks like White Raw has more Zealots. And Colossi are really good against Zealots, so we're going to see all these Zealots go down really quickly. Guardian Shield, as I was predicting, making a big difference in the Stalker battle. And these Stalkers are able to focus down these Colossi really easily. And it's probably going to make a short work of White Raw's army this game, because here's the fourth Colossi now. And yeah, just those two sentries with the Guardian Shield made a big difference in this game. And we'll see how White Raw adjusts in game two. See you there.